I'm getting used to this nice picture. It's weird.
All right, so if you want to go ahead and hit enter or ready on IRC there, it's all typed out. Let's see. Oh, sure. But it just... Gotcha. Okay. As long as it's, like, synced with IRC. Okay. Okay.
So just tell me when to start.
Yeah. Yep. According to race spot.
You press start for me.
All right. So we're getting started with Mega Man 3 here. And Cool Kid's getting started right here with Gemini Man. It gets off started off with a very, very hard level because Mega Man 3, compared to its predecessors, is very, very laggy. And so when you're in a stage like Gemini Man, where a lot of the later parts have a lot of very, very tight jumps with pits in between each jump, it becomes very, very dangerous. And so we'll just be seeing that. And so you guys know, in addition to what you're seeing on screen, Cool Kid here is live at DreamHack playing this. And then in addition to that, we have a bunch of racers on SRL joining the same very same race. So on stream, we also have Raindrop Dry, Fast at CC, and Vsan TA, who are all very, very good racers of this game. But I will mostly be commentating Cool Kid's run. So, yep, so he's going right through Gemini Man, and what you've seen so far is you might be wondering why the music has died down and why the former penguin machines there are now just totally glitched out. What he did was where normally in the stage you would see Proto Man, instead of that, he was able to kind of slide past the Proto Man screen, and before his slide ended, he jumped out of his slide so that the game kind of never saw that he actually stopped. And so he slid through the screen and then jumped right down into the pit. And Proto Man never appeared, and the game didn't really know what to do. And so instead, it just kind of continues. And that's why the Proto Man's music ends, and the game doesn't know what music to play next. And so it just doesn't play any music at all until this boss screen. Cool Kid actually had a wonderful Gemini Man stage
my
there.
Hands are, my hands are so sweaty.
his hands are sweaty. It's official. And now we're back with music in this Gemini Man fight. It's a very, very dangerous fight, and you have to kind of switch between the two Gemini Man kind of clones to deal damage equally. If you only deal damage to one of them, then it'll be a lot slower because you're trying to minimize the invulnerability frames and do as much damage to them as possible.
So actually, I would say for being a like live run, live setting, that was a very, very good stage.
Yeah. So looking at our other racers, Vsan just finished. Raindrop Dry is finishing up with one health left, and Facet CC is headed into Hardman stage. Looks like they're doing a bit of a different route here. I didn't see if Facet CC did Magnet Man first, but one thing you can do actually in this game is there are kind of two distinct routes that you can take. You can start with Magnet Man, which makes it a bit easier, or you can start with Gemini Man, which is a bit faster but harder. And the main difference between the two routes is that basically because Magnet Man's weapon, you know, the classic idea of the Mega Man series is that you finish a boss, you get his weapon, and then you have access to that weapon for the rest of the game. Magnet Man's weapon is very, very useful. You'll see it later on in Cool Kid's route. But if you do Magnet Man first, then it's kind of this homing weapon. And it just makes a lot of stages very easy. Or it makes it quite a bit easier. Whereas if you get Gemini Man first, if you fight Gemini Man first, you have earlier access to his kind of secondary bonus, which is the Rush Jet. And Rush Jet makes a lot of stages faster. It can make them a little bit easier as well. But especially headed into Magnet Man stage, you'll see that the Rush Jet is helpful, and we'll get to that later on. So now we just cruise right through Needle Man stage, and here is the boss here. There's a little bit of luck, very nice fight. There's a little bit of luck to Needle Man. His jumps can be different heights. And so, can you just hit the control button? What happens with Needleman is that his different jumps are different heights, basically. And so kind of if you're able to time your lasers correctly, then you'll always hit him. But if one of your lasers misses, it seems, my understanding is that a Gemini Man laser is made up of kind of a few different sprites. This is just kind of what I've, how I understand it. And so if you, because it's so different, because it's different like little pieces of the Gemini Man laser, and because Mega Man 3 is so kind of sensitive to lag, it feels like, if you miss a shot with the Gemini laser, then you have all these different little tiny pieces of the laser constantly on screen, and so that can lag the game. Fortunately, we didn't see it. We might see it in the laser, in the refights later, but this is another very, very difficult part of the run. Mega Man 3 just kind of, because Mega Man 3 is the first Mega Man game to introduce the slide mechanic, unlike Mega Man 1 and 2, you suddenly have this totally new movement feature. And so it can be very difficult to use the slide. And if you're on these kind of jumping between these tiny, tiny platforms where there's pits in between them, you not only want to kind of walk and jump between each one, but you also want to be sliding as much as you can on each tiny, tiny piece of land. And so if you want to kind of maximize your speed, it can be really, really dangerous in that regard. Oh, just like that. That's rough.
Why do you have slider? That's so stupid.
So yeah, this stage can be really, really rough. Very similar to what we saw in Gemini Man before. Meanwhile, looking at our other racers, I guess Facet CC must just be doing a totally different route. And Raindrop Dry and V-San seem to be doing the same route. But the other two are in Sparkman stage, while Facet CC is finishing up Topman stage, which we haven't seen yet on Cool Kid's screen. Sparkman can be another very, very frustrating boss because he has all these different things he can do, from jumping around to a couple different spark attacks, it's pretty much those three, but it can really, really be very difficult and can cost you a lot of time just based on what he does.
That was basically... that might have been the worst pattern.
Oh, really? Okay.
That was a terrible pattern.
So Cool Kid finishes. I didn't see if V-San died, but he lost a bit of time. So Cool Kid finishes Sparkman stage, and in comparison, Raindrop Dry finishes just a bit later and just as V-San reaches Sparkman. Facet CC. We won't know really how Facet CC compares until we get done with the Robot Masters. So here we are in Magnamen stage, and this is where Cool Kid's route will gain a little bit of time over Facet CC, because he's able to, where there are these disappearing block sections throughout the stage, having the rush jet allows you to skip those and do them a lot quicker. Proto Man has a few appearances in this game, and it's actually pretty interesting because the way he jumps, a lot of people, there's a lot of mashing throughout the Mega Man series in general. But what Proto Man kind of introduces to the series is because he has these short hops, you need to not only be mashing, but you also need to be jumping certain height jumps. And so you're kind of holding A while you're mashing B. So it's a very much kind of rub your stomach while patting your head type idea. And can be difficult and takes a lot of practice to get used to. So you can see here that this is where Cool Kid's route gains a bit of time over doing Magnet Man first. Ooh, you scared me there. And so you'll see that once we finish up Magnet Man stage, Cool Kid will gain access to a very, very useful weapon. One thing, as you're entering each boss stage, one thing you can do, I guess you try it for every boss, right? I'll stop bothering you. But one thing you can do for each boss fight is you can... Nice. As you enter the screen, the boss screen, you have a one-frame window in which you can push start to open up the weapon select screen. And so it does save a little bit of time if you can get that one-frame window because when you exit the start screen, you have this kind of reappear animation, and so instead of having that reappear animation plays at the same time as the boss is loading, whereas if you weren't able to enter the start select screen, the boss would just kind of start, you know, appearing on the screen while you can't really make use of that time. So it's just kind of one more little way you can make use of time. Cool Kid is entering Hardman stage now, and we'll see how it goes. Mega Man 3 has a very, very popular soundtrack. I would say it's one of the more popular ones outside of Mega Man 2. It's kind of a love or hate it type thing, but I've heard that a lot of people really love this soundtrack. Monkeys. Always the monkeys. Do it. No, don't do it. In a lot of his practice, Cool Kid was trying this very, very tight trick there, but it's easy to waste a lot of time, and it doesn't save that much time. It's a very tight trick. Mega Man 3, unlike the other Mega Man games, has a very different weapon select screen, whereas most of them, the earlier games kind of open up this vertical screen. Mega Man 3 kind of comes up from the bottom, and you can actually save a bit of time on that weapon select screen by pushing B to cycle between the different pages of the weapon select screen rather than just needing to kind of go to page next. So you can see here, the Proto Man areas also each have kind of their own little unique architecture to them. And so that kind of makes each fight a little different in its own regard. So yep, I was asking Cool Kid a bit about it before, and it sounds like about 4 of the 8 bosses have a pretty decent luck mechanic to them, and 4 don't. I think Hardman doesn't really have any luck to him, but you can really lose a lot of time on the bosses which do have a larger luck component to them. So looking at how we are compared to one another, Facet CC has finished his 5th Robot Master going into Needleman. Again, he's doing a different route. And Cool Kid just finished Hardman, and Raindrop Dry and V-Sun also just finished Hardman. So Cool Kid, well, I'm not sure how the other racers in the race are doing, but as far as the ones we're watching, Cool Kid seems to be in the lead of the ones doing this particular route, and again, we'll see how fast its CC compares once we finish up. Snake Man has a couple different glitches to him in the level. You'll see one here where you can just bypass this larger snake mini-boss instead of dealing just all this... just a ton of damage to the big head at the end, and then bypassing him after that. You just rush jet right by him. So yeah, this has been a solid run so far. We had that one death, but besides that, things have been going quite well. I haven't... What's that?
It's just a really unfortunate... Yeah. Unfortunate, right. Stupid death, but... Can
you?
I don't think I'm the only one who has died so far.
And then we see the sneaking past the snake again right here. So yeah, like I was saying, Mega Man 3 really kind of departs quite a bit from the previous ones. You've got Mega Man 1 and 2, which, again, don't have the slide. They have these various little physics differences as well that Mega Man 3 takes care of. I think there's a bit of acceleration in the first two games, whereas Mega Man 3, if you push in the direction you go, there's no real acceleration, I think. Is that right? There's no acceleration?
No.
Okay.
You need a slide anyway, so...
Yeah, it's true. And then on top of that, you've got kind of quite a bit more lag in the third one compared to the first two. And it just sometimes kind of has a very different feel to it, it seems like. One thing you can do to speed up your runs by just a little bit is you notice that after each boss kill, Mega Man goes to the middle of the screen before you can kind of exit the level. So ideally, you try and exit each level, or you try and finish each boss off as close to the middle of the screen as possible, so that you minimize how much time Mega Man has to actually go to the middle of the screen after you finish the boss. But it really just depends on... I mean, you don't want to sacrifice your actual boss fight for being able to do that, so yeah. So Cool Kid's entering Top Man here. Looks like Raindrop, Dry, and V-Sun just finished up Snake Man. and Facet CC is somewhere in the middle of Snake Man at the moment on his own route. The people you're seeing, actually, I'm not sure exactly how exactly it goes. I know Vsan currently has the record in this game, and Facet CC, I believe, is second place, and then Cool Kid and Raindrop Dry are in the top 10 for this for the game as well. So we really have some really solid runners. And there are other solid runners in the race as well, such as Yoka. There are a whole bunch of them. I think the race, we wound up with about 35 entrants, which is pretty awesome. Yeah, so you can see just how useful that Magnet Man weapon is. It really just kind of homes in, and so if you're like on these climbing areas or making these tight jumps, which you'll see it really come in handy in Shadow Man stage, but it can really be handy to just kind of make defeating these enemies that are out of range just that much easier. So Top Man is down now. Raindrop Dry and Vsan are finishing up Top Man stage, and Facet CC is entering Spark Man stage.
Facet CC is definitely ahead of me by a pretty large margin, I would say. Shadow Man stage is a bit longer sparks, and I haven't even entered the stage yet. So. And he has weapons to speed it up as well. Those guys have the worst. I messed that up, but they have the worst hitbox in the game.
Yeah, Cool Kid hates those hitboxes. He's telling me a bit before. Here we have another Proto Man fight. But yeah, the idea behind those kind of met construction worker guys is that, you know, the bottom maybe like 3/4 of their body are invulnerable, whereas you can only shoot their heads. And so, but it's not only that, but their hitboxes are very, very odd, and so it can be a pain to hit them and finish them off. One thing unique, you'll see here just how useful Magnet Man's weapon is. Like, without it, this would be a lot more dangerous, but the sliding is still dangerous, but at least you don't have to worry about the enemies there. Everyone's favorite weapon in this game, the Top Spin. It's a very, very unique weapon, and the idea behind it is that, you know, Top Man's weapon basically makes Mega Man's body, when you do this Top Spin in the air, makes Mega Man's body a weapon of sorts. And so for the bosses that are weak to it, like Top Man there, it's a very different approach to fighting those bosses. And what you want to do when you use it is you actually want to make sure that you're top spinning directly into them, because if you take damage from something and you're invulnerable, then if you use topspin and you're invulnerable, then it actually uses kind of its weapon energy per frame, and you can just expend a whole ton of topspin energy very, very quickly. So that finished up the Robot Master stages. Cool Kid is through with that. Facet CC is in the midst of this. Of this next Doc Robot stage, and so he's got a bit of time over Cool Kid. Meanwhile, Raindrop Dry, Vsan just finished up the Doc Robot stage, the 8 Robot Master stages, and Raindrop Dry is finishing up Shadow Man. So that is one thing that's unique about this game, is that you actually have to kind of redo a lot of... They're modified versions of the stages, and some of them are just totally different and have totally different feels, but you kind of revisit the themes of these levels, and then you have to fight kind of these refights of Mega Man 2 bosses in each one. And each one have their own, you know, sets of weaknesses to the weapons you've gotten so far. So, for example, you'll remember from Mega Man 2, here's Flash Man. And so you're fighting him with your Mega Man 3 weapons. there are a few different. I'm not too clear on the different differences between the between Mega Man 3 and Rockman 3, which is what Cool Kid's playing. But one that I do know of is that that Flashman fight that you just saw in the English version, the English version. The Flash move that he does actually freezes you in place for considerably longer, whereas on the Japanese version, it's very brief, and he only has time to fire one shot out of his arm before he unfreezes you and you can move again. So it does save a bit of time there in the Rockman 3 version, in the Japanese version. One thing that's interesting to me about this game is that whereas in Mega Man 4 through 6, for the most part, most Robot Masters only have one very, very, very distinct weakness. In Mega Man 3, they actually have quite a few weaknesses, and in particular, they're weak to their own weapons. They each shot from their own weapons does 4 damage to them in the refights, and so it winds up taking 7 hits to finish them off. Of course, you don't have access to that until the refights,
look at laser.
But you do later on, and then even in the first round of fights, you can kind of approach the route differently, just depending on how exactly you want to use those boss weaknesses, because you have a lot of options there. So here we have the Spark Robot, Spark Dock Robot stage. Mega Man 2, going back to kind of boss weaknesses, Mega Man 1 and 2, well, certainly Mega Man 2, it seemed like the boss weaknesses were all over the place. Like, everyone knows, you know, Metal Blade was just about effective on everything, and each particular weapon, I think, has a couple different uses for different bosses. And Mega Man 3 kind of, I think, takes that even further, and then again, you get into Mega Man 4 onwards, where each boss has a very distinct weakness. Mega Man 1 also, I think, kind of had each boss has distinctive weaknesses, but even then, it's a bit flexible. You can see here, Cool Kid is despawning those little spark robots by letting them go off screen, and then continuing onwards after that, when it's useful. Quick robot. The search thing, I mean, this game just has some really, really odd weapons in general. The top spin, we already mentioned, is odd. The hard knuckle is a very, very strange weapon that, you know, is immobile at first and then quickly speeds up and accelerates. And then the search snake, which you just saw in that quick robot fight, is very odd as well and has a very unique kind of mechanic to it. Needleman, the Needleman's revisit is quite a bit different from the first stage. You'll see later on that it just kind of becomes very, very different from the first time around you visit the stage. So it looks like, I'm not sure if everyone's doing the same order, but everyone seems to be in the Needleman stage right now. Facet CC is a bit of a lead, and it's very likely that that lead just came from that his route choice, just because he wound up kind of using it to his advantage.
That was an extremely, extremely good.
Oh, nice.
Fight. Thank you.
So you can see here, Cool Kid is not only using the rush jet to get across the screen and not only going at the top to avoid all the enemies, but he's also jumping off the screen as much as he can to avoid lag as much as possible. This game really, really has a ton of lag management to it. There's just something about it that makes it lag so frequently, and so you need to adjust your strats and really kind of plan around that lag to minimize it as much as possible. Not only for the sake of time, but because, especially on those kind of tight little pieces of land, it can be very, very difficult, and you can die very easily from lag surprising you in a way you weren't expecting.
I lost so much time in this stage.
I've got a weird shadow on me. So Cool Kid finishes up the Needleman visit. Raindrop Dry might be doing a different order, I think. But we'll see after the Doc Robot stages are done.
I was gonna do a cool trick, but it was on the wrong pixel.
Oh, okay. It'll be hard to tell how kind of everyone's comparing to one another until we're out of the Doc Robot stages. I don't know if everyone's doing them in the same order. Unlike the 8 Robot Masters, where you actually get a weapon and are able to use that, in the Doc Robot stages, I don't think the order really matters, because you don't actually get anything from them, is my understanding.
Yeah, it does not matter.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Yeah, weapon drops are quite a curse in the entire series. because you can see kind of that when you get an energy drop or a weapon drop, then all the way from, I think, Mega Man 1 through 9, through 10, it kind of pauses you a little bit while your energy or weapon energy refills. So if you get that at the wrong time, such as over these pits, then it can be really dangerous. It can surprise you, and you'll, you know, hold your jump button for a little less time than you were expecting to, and you'll just fall right into the pit. Especially if it's a short weapon energy drop, because then you can't. It's so short that you can't even react to it. Whereas if it's a larger weapon or energy, weapon energy or energy refill, then you can actually at least react. But for the shorter ones, it just kind of catches you off guard and messes you up. Okay, so Facet CC is now into Wily 1, and Cool Kid is just about to enter him. And then Raindrop Dry and Vsan are... Vsan is actually just finishing up the Doc Robot stages now, and Raindrop Dry is a little bit further behind, finishing up the Needleman Doc Robot stage.
Facet CC is definitely on a good pace. He's really far ahead of us.
Another thing that's changed a little bit throughout the different Mega Man games is kind of how you exit that start screen. Mega Man 1 is very kind of infamous for being able to exploit that little recovery out of the start screen animation to beat bosses very, very quickly. Then it kind of continues in Mega Man 2, where you can use it to your falling speed actually resets back to zero when you pause in Mega Man 2, and so it has a kind of distinct feature there. I don't know if it necessarily has any uses in Mega Man 3. By this point, it's seeing a lot less kind of exploiting use. This boss has a lot of luck to it, whereas the direction, this boss basically spits out a bunch of turtles, and while the direction of each turtle is always the same for between each run, so you know at least which direction the next turtle will go, it ranges just when the robot will actually shoot out the turtle. And so the robot can just take as much time as he want to actually give you the next thing that you need to progress the fight. But how did that fight go, would you say?
It was pretty bad. Did Beast Man die?
Oh, I didn't see. I think you were ahead of him, so I don't think so. I didn't see, though.
Let's see how fast that CC gets in one cycle.
Don't get distracted now. So if you remember, in Mega Man 2, whereas Mega Man 1's, the special weapon is basically just the magnet beam, Mega Man 2 then introduces the three different... Oh, I'm going to be quiet here, but we want a one cycle here, so let's see if Kulka can get it. You basically time your damage so that you can earn vulnerable for as long as possible, and then you mash and time your jumps to be able to get the one cycle on this boss, so let's hope for it. And he did get it.
I was kind of lucky.
Well, lucky? How so? Oh, just that you got it generally. Yeah.
Yes, felt like.
Here we have everyone's favorite theme from this game, typically. But yeah, if you don't get that one cycle, then you might see it on stream. We'll see. But basically, what happens is, you saw kind of that the boss's entry where it needed to piece by piece go across the screen and form itself. Well, that happens again if you're not able to one cycle him, and he goes back to the other side of the screen. And so you can really just waste a ton of time if you don't get that one cycle. But yeah, so Mega Man 2 introduces a few different kind of items that you can get to move around. And the idea is that, you know, in that game, item one is just this little elevator you can spawn that just flies upwards. Item two is a jet that just solely takes you horizontally. And then item three is something that climbs up a wall. Whereas in Mega Man 3, you'll use it as very, very different kind of items. Rush Coil, which you spawn on the ground, and it's basically a trampoline that you can jump off of. You especially see that early on because you start out with it. Rush Marine, which I'm not you did see it a little bit earlier on when it was necessary, but besides that, you can't really use it to speed you up, I believe. And then Rush Jet, which you've been seeing throughout the game and is tremendously useful. The reason it's Rush Jet is so useful, while it's not as fast as item 2 in Mega Man 2, you do have full control over it, and so you can use it vertically. It doesn't really push you in any direction. You have just full control over it and can take it in any way you want. So we have the refights. Every Mega Man has its signature refights, and Mega Man 3 is no exception. So like I said before, each boss actually takes 4 damage from its own weapon, and so that comes in handy in just about in a lot of the refights. In some of the refights, such as Needle Man here, because the Gemini Man laser does so much more damage than the actual Needle Man weapon, you'll use that instead of his own weapon. But it can really be useful. And then Cool Kid, so he doesn't have to re-enter the weapon select screen, Cool Kid continues right into Gemini Man refight, so that he doesn't have to waste any time on the weapon select screen. It's actually interesting to me just how much those refights are routed out specifically to minimize how often you need to go into the weapon select screen. That's seen throughout the entire series. So jump. Famous top spin again.
Didn't want to grab his HD, but whatever.
Shadowblade, I would say, is the kind of the staple that you'll see in a lot of Mega Man games, where it's just like this bladed weapon that is just overall very, very useful. You certainly saw it in Mega Man 2 with the Metal Blade, where you can just fire it in 8 different directions, and the Shadow Blade is very similar to that, and it actually kind of has, while it doesn't travel as far, or it probably has a similar speed, but while it doesn't travel as far, it has this boomerang effect, which kind of has its own little feel to it. So looking at our other racers, Facet CC is continuing a wonderful run. I don't think he's really made many mistakes at all. Cool Kid and Raindrop Dry and Vsan are both in the refights, and Cool Kid is continuing along.
Sorry, so next stage, final stage.
Oh, next stage is the final stage. Oh, did Facet CC finish?
Yeah,
finished. That's the end.
Yeah, yeah,
so
he finished.
Really a solid run.
Yeah, definitely.
Could you have Dot Dun typed out for us in IRC just to make sure when he finishes, and we'll call it out. Thanks. So Cool Kid's finishing up. He's coming up on the last fight here. Alright, get ready, that's it, right? Or no? Is it?
Yeah.
That's it.
36 something.
Yeah.
I think the timer started late.
Nice. Okay.
Where did I finish? Second.
Okay, so yeah, second place right after Facet CC. Thank you very much, Cool Kid. Wonderful run. Thank you guys very much for watching. We'll probably be moving on. I mean, everyone's done at this point. What's that? Oh, a race PB for Cool Kid. Nice.
By how much?